worried about in Lille, you know. Really, 6 months no passport, really people worry. Because people travel, students going overseas, some going for medical treatment, some for already planned holiday, you know, for so many reasons. Now, yeah, current issue at the moment here, in Miri in particular, it is employment agenda, employment policies. On the presently, it is vis-a-vis our oil companies. Present case is our national oil, Petronas, and a lot of statements have been made. And again, I'm pleased that the federal Petronas, they are coming over to see our deputy chief minister, Dr. Amar Nakasuka, and our state secretary reported today. They'll be seeing them. What is more importantly is the policy, the general policy of national oil company and other oil companies operating in Miri and Tulu. Not only one company, we should be looking at other companies. What are the policies of employment? What is the development program for our own people, especially in Sarawak? And rightly so, people in Sarawak want to know, because oil and gas was first. Special oil, 1910. We are talking about 116 years ago. Sarawak share the people of Miri and Sarawak is a lot. Having in this oil and gas for so long, it is definitely not rational or unacceptable to say that Sarawakians do not possess qualification to fill in post that should be filled by Sarawakians. So we would like to have that employment policies and also development. How to develop Sarawak's talents if after 116 years and we still say that Sarawakians are not capable? That cannot be right. If that is the case, policy of training and bringing Sarawakians must have a relook. If you see 100 over years, it is like this. And of course, Petronas came in after Petroleum Development Act 1974. Now, Rizzi is talking about 40 over years. And from what I gather, we have a lot of Sarawakians working overseas in other oil and gas companies. Because they were trained from Miri. Last time from that group, they were saying the same thing. And they were in America, in Saudi Arabia, in the Middle East countries, and also in Africa. So now they are back here because of oil price. But previously they were in oil and gas here. So we have. More importantly, we must look at the policy. It must be fair and transparent. So that people would be like I say, we should have a relook at the overall policies of oil and gas companies.
So, can I ask a question? We've been talking about policies and about policies of this people because it's employment now. But so far, what is actually this? Is there any quota? How many executives, non-executives, is there any firm quota given?
The one I do not know. I will not be able to answer.
Otherwise, you don't know.
It is
no best of how many people should be local, how many should be from other part of the part of Malaysia, competing jobs in Sarawak. If there is any. There is a firm statement like, okay, the first two highest position must be filled by Sarawakian. Two-thirds of the executive must be filled by, then it is here.
The important issue now would be, we must have a relook. What happened before, and what we want to see should happen. Two different things that happened before, cannot do much now.
Yeah.
But we must look forward.
Look forward.
Yes. Arising from this, what can we learn? What can we learn from this? Yeah. And important thing is an overall holistic approach, and including even, you know, the conservation, preservation, because oil and gas, is depleting. Yeah, it's depleting.
Finance resources.
We are looking at, is that 10 years, 15 years, or 20 years? If you immediately pump, then maybe 10 years, tada, resources, no more oil and gas. If you have a kind of quota, so to speak, a maximum number of barrels per day, and then at least instead of 10 years, we may have 15 years. Yeah, at least they have more years. Correct, and then hopefully then by then also oil price will be better. The overall holistic approach, looking at the industry as a whole.
That's great to know.